You've seen our video on the 1UZ, you've seen our video on the 3UZ, but today we're going to talk about the least loved UZ engine of them all, and that's the 2UZ. So sit down, grab your popcorn, get comfy, because today I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the Toyota 2UZ-FE. As the name suggests, the 2UZ is the second engine in the UZ engine family. It came before the 3UZ and it came after the 1UZ. Now, where the 1UZ and the 3UZ were designed mostly for sports cars and luxury cars, the 2UZ-FE had a completely different application set, which was trucks and SUVs. With that being said, Toyota had to make a lot of changes to the 2UZ to make it best suited for those different applications. Now, the biggest change that they made from the 1UZ and the 3UZ onto the 2UZ is the fact that they moved the displacement up from 4 liters on the 1UZ up to 4.7 liters on the 2UZ. Now, the reason that they did this was mostly to increase torque for towing and hauling. Other than the change to the displacement and the cylinder block material, which we'll talk about in just a little bit, the 2UZ is actually pretty similar to the 1UZ. It's a dual overhead cam, 4 valves per cylinder with aluminum heads. It was in production from 1998 all the way up until 2012, although in most places it started to die off in 2009, and Toyota completely replaced it by the 1UR and the 3UR in 2010. To increase displacement from 4 liters to 4.7 liters, Toyota increased the bore from 87.5 millimeters to 94 millimeters and increased the stroke from 82.5 millimeters to 84 millimeters. Typically with truck engines, you'll see bore and stroke equal or stroke be longer to help increase low end power. So it's interesting to see the oversquare design on the 2UZ. If you want a better explanation of how bore and stroke work and how they affect each other and how it affects total power output, go check out our video on that. I'll leave it linked up in one of these corners. It explains it in a lot better detail. Aside from bore and stroke, the 2UZ block is very similar to the 1UZ. It's based on in design and dimension. It has a 90 degree V angle, 21 millimeter cylinder bank offset, and a bore pitch of 105.5 millimeters. An interesting change made in the bottom end is the reduction from 6 main bearing journals to 5. In the first few years of production, the 2UZ used a typical cable mechanical throttle body, but as Toyota wanted to increase power and efficiency, they moved to an electronic throttle body in 2002. As far as fuel and spark goes, the 2UZ-FE uses sequential multi-port fuel injection system with 8 four-hole fuel injectors and a mass airflow sensor. It's also equipped with Toyota's direct ignition system, which uses individual coils for all 8 cylinders instead of a distributor. Of all the changes that Toyota made to the 2UZ-FE throughout its lifetime, the absolute most important change that they made was the addition of their VVTi system, which allowed intake valve timing to be changed on the fly based on load, RPM, and throttle amount. With this, they're able to change valve overlap, and that has a very big impact on power output and fuel efficiency. Another interesting thing that you find on top of every 2UZ engine is Toyota's variable length intake manifold, which you'll also find on the 3UZ, that essentially takes it from a short intake runner to a long intake runner. The length of the intake runner has a big impact on where the engine makes power most efficiently, so it's really good to see this kind of feature because it allowed the 2UZ to make a lot of low-end power and a lot of top-end power, where typically you'll only see an engine be able to do one or the other very efficiently. Inside the VVTi 2UZ-FE, you'll also find lighter pistons compared to the earlier engines and oil jets to help cool the pistons down. Toyota also increased the compression ratio of the VVTi version to 10 to 1 to further improve fuel efficiency. To recap on some of this basic info, we're looking at a production run from 1998 all the way up until 2011. A cast iron cylinder block, cast aluminum cylinder heads, dual overhead cams, 32 valves, later versions having Toyota VVTi system, their variable length intake manifold system, a 10 to 1 compression ratio, and some of the later models had a lighter rotating assembly. With all that out of the way, let's take a look at some of the applications and some of the common problems that you'll see with the 2UZ. It came in a variety of different Toyota products, and like I mentioned at the start, it was mostly trucks and SUVs that this engine was used in. The 2UZ was equipped in the Lexus GX470 and LX470. It was also in the Toyota 4Runner, Land Cruiser, Sequoia, and the Tundra. Just like the 1UZ and the 3UZ, the 2UZ had a lot of changes over the years, but the biggest and most important change of them all was Toyota's VVTi system. And to save some time, I'll put some power figures on the screen so that you can see the changes that they made and how it increased power output. As you can tell from these numbers, the 2UZ ended up with 52 more horsepower and 22 more pound-feet of torque at the end compared to when it started. The largest jump occurred when Toyota added their VVTi system, which again is their most important change, like I mentioned. From those of you who don't particularly care how an engine performs in stock form, let's take a look at what the 2UZ can do with the help of some aftermarket part. Luckily, since it's mostly based on the 1UZ, most most of the top end parts for a 1UZ will actually bolt right onto it, which opens up a significant amount of aftermarket parts. Now, just like the 1UZ, the Terminator Cobra Supercharger or Eaton M90 is a common addition to the 2UZ. With the addition of fuel injectors and an exhaust, you can easily expect a 2UZ to make over 380 horsepower at 6 PSI or 440 horsepower at 10 PSI. Of course, at that point, you might want to start looking at a built bottom end, but the point stands. This engine is actually pretty good for forced induction. At one point, Toyota did make a supercharger kit for this engine, which increased power by 118 horsepower, but that kit is no longer available. If you look hard enough, you can still find it used on eBay, but you're kind of better off just not going with it because parts availability for a discontinued supercharger is going to be a little bit problematic. Now, there are two big issues when it comes to cramming boost down a 2UZ. That's two bolt main caps and relatively weak connecting rods. This is the important distinction that makes the 2UZ a lot less popular than the 1UZ and the 3UZ. But those engines have four bolt main caps, the 2UZ only has two bolt main caps. Now this doesn't make it impossible to boost the 2UZ, and it doesn't make it the weakest V8 ever, but it is an important distinction where four bolt main caps are significantly stronger and have a lot more clamping force to keep the crankshaft in place and keep it from moving around. Also, the stock rods are pretty thin on most 2UZ variants and can fail often in totally stock form. So if you're throwing boost at a 2UZ, upgraded rods are generally a good idea for longevity, otherwise you could potentially be playing with a time bomb. Just like other great Toyota engines like the 1JZ and the 2JZ and many others, the 2UZ has a ridiculously strong block, partially thanks to the fact that it's cast iron instead of cast aluminum. The 1UZ is praised by people all over the internet for its ability to hold up to like 1,000 horsepower on a stock block, but the 2UZ can hold up to double that in some instances. Again, this is what happens when you use cast iron instead of cast aluminum. So overall, the 2UZ is actually a lot like the 1UZ, except it was mildly redesigned for use in trucks and SUVs instead of sports cars and luxury cars. With the application change in mind, the most important distinction of the 2UZ compared to any other UZ engine is that it has a lot more displacement and a cast iron block. The 2UZ is a really strong and really torquey motor, and compared to some of the competitors' truck engines, it is actually pretty low on displacement, but it has comparable amounts of horsepower and torque, which kind of just shows you how well engineered this engine was, because if you were to look at something like the Chevy engines of the time, you're talking about a 5.7 liter instead of a 4.7 liter, while that 4.7 liter is still making a comparable amount of power. So that's it for this short video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please smash the thumbs up button. It really helps out the channel, really helps the channel grow. While you're down there, get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos. Drop a comment, let me know what you want to see in the future. Also, let me know what you thought about this video. Was there anything I missed? Anything you want to add? Do you think I'm an idiot? You know, just let me know. And I'll see you guys in the next one.